we're turning the engine
so we can see if our cam spins, and let's see if I can do it right there. You can see, and I'm turning it right now. I'm moving it, and it doesn't turn. You can see I'm just not turning. So we're gonna open the valve cover, and we're gonna discover more things and see what's going on. I think either I want to say the camshaft bolt, center bolt broke, or timing chain broke. No, I don't think the timing chain broke. I will hear it. I will hear a big noise every time I turn this thing. So from the center cam bolt, the Banos sprocket, and the cam, 1, 2, I think 3 lugs spin, and I think there's a break right here. The rest of the cam is not spinning, and I'm gonna put a mark here so you see. See if I can put a mark. Well, there's a mark I make. I'm gonna mark this and see how it doesn't move. You're gonna see how it's not moving. And I have here, see, there, you see that this is spinning, right? It's spinning correctly. There's tension in the chain. And you see this love turning. Making sure my tool is not gonna fall. But from here, this is not turning. See, the mark is still there. The rest obviously doesn't turn.
So the first step we did is we lock the crankshaft with our timing tool, and for kick and giggles we check the timing and the tool. We did everything we could to see if it was on time, but it's not, the tool is not going in. Right there, it should slide easily, and it's not, it's just a hair off. Let's see if I can get a bit, get better view here, maybe. Yeah, right there, you can see it's not going in, and we have our timing marks both on top. And with the crank locked, that means it's out of time when the tool doesn't go in. And that is our, basically that is our timing. And also, I haven't even checked this, but I'm not going to, I'm not gonna waste time in putting, testing the tool here. This one. And 52 and 51. I mean, I guess I can try really quick. And it doesn't align. Oh, wait a minute. No, yeah, it does. Nope. No, it doesn't. It's a little, just a hair off. It's not too much, but that is enough. If the tool doesn't go in, out of timing. Probably happens when that cam broke. Anyway, now in order to, I don't think I can, no matter what tool I have, I'm gonna be able to take these bolts right here. This one's right here. This one's right here, I can't. But not this ones. Anyway, so for that, we're gonna take the fuel injector rail out, and then we're gonna work on the springs. We're gonna use our special tool.
Okay, so we remove the bolts for the springs, and then we're removing the caps. And in this case, there come the numbers on regular position. Sometimes they're, you know, upside down. In this case, they were not, which leads me to believe usually they come upside down. Let's see this number right here. It's normal. Okay, so right here, that's where the cam broke, right there. So we're just gonna take this part of the cam to see if this bearing surfaces are fine. If not, I think it's toasted, but we're just gonna look it up. So this is where we add basically BMW 10 Indy Mechanic Zero. We'll see. I think this head is fine. It's just a little, this one is not too bad. I can't feel any, but it is worn, but I'm gonna go with it. I'm gonna polish it a little bit with sandpaper. It's not that bad. In all of them, I thought they were gonna be completely scratched, but they're not. They're not. Unfortunately, they're not. So we're gonna get this. Yeah, it doesn't. It's not that bad. Let's see this one. No, I can't feel anything and I can't see anything. And let me, because I thought this was gonna be the, I see a little scratch right there, but it's not. It is a scratch right there. I'm gonna see if I can polish it. If not, then I'm still gonna go with it. I don't think that little tiny scratch is gonna do anything. And so we have the come out. And yeah, it looks very bad. Not sure what happened. I thought it got stuck, but if it got stuck, this is really bad, but it's like polish, you know, it's not rough. So I think there was a lot of lubrication. It did get stuck at some point and it broke, probably. I think that's what happened. Not really sure what happened. I think somebody worked on it and got something way too tight, I think, but nothing felt weird. So nothing felt weird when I was taking the cups, but the cups are bad. So I'm just gonna put new cups here. This one is the main one, the front one, and is really bad, and I'm just gonna replace it with this one. That's the difference. And then this is number one. It's really scratched up, and I have a replacement here. These are used parts from another head that I have here. So, and we're gonna use this cam. And yeah, when I take this cam out, we're gonna compare the surfaces and see where we are. Okay, so we're gonna put oil in the bearing cups. The bearing cups, but we're gonna put oil in the bearing seats of the head. Right here, we're gonna put oil. Now that we're ready, we polish them. We don't have any scratches. We're able to
just polish them. We didn't need to send it to the machine, just quick sandpaper from 500 to all the way to 2500. And now we're gonna put oil. I'm gonna put a lot of oil, lots of oil. So lots of oil. I want this soaking on. And also our camshaft, we're gonna put a lot of oil in the bearing journals, a lot of oil, lots of oil. We already clean it up, polish it, everything super clean, a lot of oil in this journals. Lots of oil, and then we're just gonna put it in. So, like that. And then we're gonna put just a cup. We're gonna start with number 3, just because it's easy. Just because it's easy to install. Just to get over really quick, what I do is just grab this cups with sandpaper, 500. I start with 500 and I finish all the way to 2500, and that's what I do. And then I just clean them up and I'm gonna put them in there. I'm gonna put more oil before I start. Let's say we keep putting more oil now that we have our cum in place. And we're gonna start with just one in the middle. We're gonna start with number 3. We put a lot of oil. Number 3, so 1, 2, this is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and we put a lot of oil again, and we put a lot of oil in the cup, and we're gonna make sure it's backwards, or the letters and numbers are the normal position, but the number is backwards. One bolt here, and one bolt there. We're just gonna hand tight it with a Torx 30. Tight. We're gonna put the big one. We put more oil there. We put more oil in the cap. And it goes, it can only go one way. So I believe is with this
notch up. Let's see if I'm right. No, sorry, it's the contrary. With that notch down is the only way it can go. And what I make sure is the front is flush, because it moves a little bit, but once you put the bolt, it will line up, but make sure it's flush with the front. And I think it works better with a smaller driver here. I like to go hand tight. I don't like to use the electric tool. This is just 10 newton meters, so it's very, very little. So now I'm gonna go with number 6. Always oil, oil, oil. So oil. Oil here. And same thing, the number down. Upside down, two right here, one, two, three, four, five. Go like that, one by one, easy, slow. Try to concentrate without paying too much attention to the video, because I don't want to drop a bolt in the head and look for it for hours. Have the risk, if I drop a bolt, I have the risk of it can go, the holes of this head are big enough to go through the crankcase oil pan. Now we're going to torque this. So we're gonna go number 1 and number 6. Then number 3, 1, 2, 3. Number 4. Number 2. Number 5. And then the main bearing. Well, it's not the main bearing, but the seal bearing. Okay, we're ready to put the springs.